Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. You are here because you have purchased or plan to purchase one of our PN series pressure sensors. In this video, we are going to go over the installation guidelines of these sensors. So let's get started. So here you have the Learn More section on our website for our PN series pressure sensors. In this video, we are going over the installation guidelines for these sensors. These sensors are pretty easy to install, but there are a few things to consider. For example, when installing them into the application, you want to make sure that there is no pressure applied in the application. You also want to make sure that you insert these sensors into the correct process connection using the appropriate tightening torque. And finally, if the media being measured is viscous or contains solids, you want to have the process connection facing downward to avoid clogging. If this is not possible, we do offer our PI series pressure sensors that have a flush measuring cell. Next, we talk about using these sensors in steam applications. Since steam is a high temperature, we recommend using a steam pigtail or siphon tube to protect the sensor from these high temperatures. In this paragraph, we talk about the technology that is used with our steam pigtail because it converts steam back to water, known as condensate, and this lowers the temperature of the media to protect the sensor. In the chart below, you can determine what the temperature of the media will be where the sensor sees it. So for example, if the steam is applying 150 PSI and the ambient temperature is 80 degrees, you can go to the x-axis of the chart at 150, go up to the curve of 80 degrees Fahrenheit, and you can determine that the PN sensor will see about 128 degrees Fahrenheit at its measuring cell. So you need to confirm that the sensor can handle that temperature. Finally, we show you the steam pigtail that we offer. The part number is UP0011, and it works with any of our PN sensors that have a quarter inch female process connection. A few things to note with this sensor is that you need to fill it with water to ensure that the condensate is in the loop to protect the sensor from the steam temperatures. You also want to mount this pigtail vertically. And finally, like the PN sensors when they're installed by themselves, you want to make sure that when you're installing and removing the pigtail, that there is no pressure applied to the system. And one thing to note is that whether there is pressure applied or not, the components can still be hot, so you need to be careful. So now let me show you how to navigate to the datasheet of your specific part number so that you can see the technical details on your part. In this video, I'm using the PN7299. So if you search that part number and hit enter, you will see a small picture and small description of your specific part number. If you click on the part number in the orange font, it'll take you to the full data sheet of this sensor. Here you can find the technical details and then the downloads tab where you can find the operating instructions. Finally, if you go back to the top of your page, here where it says sensors with digital display for industrial applications, type PE and PN, if you click on this, it takes you back to the overview of our PN series pressure sensors. And here you can find the orange Learn More button, which will bring you back to the Learn More section for our PN series pressure sensors. And you can find the Setup and Support section to find the installation guidelines. So that concludes this Tech Insights video on the installation guidelines of our PN series pressure sensors. As always, you can check out our Learn More section on our website for helpful information on any of our products. Feel free to contact us at 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.